One thing that you can also do is to train your brain to handle stress. And this is really important because going into the future, when you start working, you will have many instances that you would have to handle, to deal with stress and handle stress. So it's a good time to actually train your brain to start handling stress. Many a times you may feel guilty that, oh, you haven't performed much or you haven't progressed much in your PhD. But even a small progress that you make is a progress. So always cherish that and celebrate that. It could be as simple as writing the abstract of a new paper. I mean, that is an achievement. You have achieved something. So that is a way to feel happy, feel motivated, and continue that the work that you are doing. So every small activity, every small achievement is an achievement. So use that as a way to keep yourself motivated and to continue and get rid of the stress. You can also visit university counseling services. Almost all universities have counseling services on campus, or if not, you can find a counselor off campus and go and visit them, share your concerns and try to address that. Also keep in mind that whatever you learn in a PhD is not wasted. You know, what you're learning in a PhD, and I have mentioned that in some of my earlier videos as well, is you're learning a skill to problem solve. You're identifying a problem, you're finding different ways in which that problem could be solved, and you are using your critical thinking to actually figure out which is the best way to solve it. I mean, that is a skill. That is what is PhD in my opinion. Finding out a way to solve a problem. And step out of your PhD, you can still use that knowledge. It is a training. Now, coming back to project management, I think the best way to handle stress is project manage. Take your PhD as a project, as a full-time job. Decide what you're going to do on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Keep Saturday and Sunday free for relaxing, to get rid of your stress. But 5 days, if you plan your day properly, decide what you're going to do and achieve that, I think that itself will help you a lot, because it will not create any stress. You would have figured out a way of what you want to achieve. I guess the stress comes in when you feel you're lagging behind. So you might have to complete something, you're procrastinating it, you're not doing it. And then when the deadline comes, you're like, oh, I'm stressed, I'm freaked out, what should I do? I don't know what to do. And that's not the right thing. If you would have planned this properly, maybe it is writing a research article, preparing for your candidacy, or whatever that activity or the event would have been, if you would have done it properly in a timely manner, I don't think that would have resulted in a stress. Also remember, there's always a solution for stress. I mean, whenever you think about what is causing you the stress, there is always a solution for that. I see many a time students are concerned or stressed because they don't know how to program something or how to simulate something. What is the solution for that? Just go and learn a new programming language that you need, or a simulation software that you need. Once you learn, spend half a month or a week, spend time on that. The next thing you realize is that the thing that you're worried about is no longer the worry. You have figured that out. So overall, I think stress, there would be stress, there is going to be stress, but it is up to you how you're going to handle that. And I think this is a skill, and you will realize when you finish your PhD and you look at yourself and compare yourself 2 or 3 years ago, how you were when you started your PhD, you would see a real big difference. And that is one of the things that you will learn from your PhD. Just to recap, how you should handle stress: start a hobby, go out for a coffee, start doing some exercise, catch up with friends, project plan your time properly, manage your milestones. And if you just follow these simple steps, you will be cruising, no problems at all, guaranteed. I hope this video was useful to you, and I hope you follow some of these ideas that I have shared here to manage your stress during your PhD. Just take it easy, have fun. PhD should be enjoyable, it should not be stressful. Alright, so that concludes my talk on managing stress. Have a big smile on your face after I finish this video, and remember that you can manage stress and you will manage stress.